Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create coffee latte art. For your convenience, I provided this photo as a base to work on, as well as this black and white clip art of a flower. Their links are in my video's description or project files. The graphic itself could also be a logo or even text. The first step is to convert our graphic into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively, as well as replacing it with a different graphic without having to redo most of the effects. To do this, click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel and click Convert to Smart Object. We'll place it onto the coffee cup image. If your Move tool isn't active, press V on your keyboard. Drag the graphic onto the tab of the base photo, and without releasing your mouse or pen, drag it down and release. Reduce the graphic's opacity so we can see the photo under it. To resize and adjust the perspective of the graphic, open the Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. To adjust its size, go to a corner and press and hold Alt or Option as we drag it in or out. To adjust its perspective, go to a bottom corner and press and hold Ctrl-Alt-Shift on Windows or Command-Option-Shift on a Mac and drag it out. To reposition it, go inside the Transform's bounding box and drag the image. To rotate it, go to a corner and drag it clockwise or counterclockwise to an angle you like. Then press Enter or Return. We can now increase its opacity back to 100%. Since the nature of foamed milk doesn't have sharp corners or edges, I'll show you a quick, effective way to round out our graphic. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. I'll blur it 6 pixels. Keep in mind, the more we blur it, the more it'll be rounded out ultimately. Go to Image, Adjustments, and Threshold. The default amount is 128. Dragging the threshold to the left constricts all the shapes, while dragging it to the right expands them. Choose a threshold that looks good to you. For this graphic, I'll make it 114. Keep in mind, if the corners are too round or conversely too sharp, you can always go back to adjust the amount of blur. Open the Channels panel. If you don't see it, go to Window and Channels. Control-click or Command-click any of the channel thumbnails, which selects the tones of the entire image. Open back the Layers panel. Invert the selection by pressing Ctrl or Command-Shift-I. To see it as a quick mask, press Q on your keyboard. Revert it back into a selection by pressing Q again. To restrict the selection to just our graphic, open the Lasso tool and press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag the tool around your graphic. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to the graphic. Convert it into a smart object as well. Double-click an empty area of the layer to open its Layer Style window. Click Color Overlay. Click the color box, and when the color picker opens, pick White. The blend mode is normal, and the opacity is 100%. Click Satin and the color box. In the hexadecimal field, type in F6EDC5. The blend mode is multiply, the opacity is 100%, and the angle is 90 degrees. The distance is 30 pixels, and the size is also 30 pixels. The contour is linear. Click Bevel and Emboss. The style is emboss, the technique is smooth, and the depth is 210%. The direction is down, the size is 30 pixels, and the soften is 5 pixels. Use global light is unchecked. The angle is 47 degrees, and the altitude is 37 degrees. The highlight mode is linear dodge, the color is white, and the opacity is 20%. The shadow mode is hard light. Click the color box and type in 582C19. Its opacity is also 20%. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. Lastly, we'll distort the overall shape and then add air bubbles to our latte art. Go to Filter, Distort, and Zigzag. The style is out from center, the amount is -30, and the ridges is 6. Go back to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 1 pixel. We'll make a composite snapshot of our visible image so we can add air bubbles to the art. Press Ctrl-Alt-Shift-E on Windows or Command-Option-Shift-E on a Mac. Let's zoom into the latte art by opening our Zoom tool and dragging it over the top of the coffee cup. Open the Patch tool. At the top, we have a choice of 2 patch modes, Normal and Content Aware. Choose Normal. There are also 2 buttons, Source and Destination. When the Source button is selected, draw a selection within the art and drag it outside the art and release. Then deselect it. Notice it copied the outside texture and then blended it onto the art. When the Destination button is selected, draw a selection outside the art and drag it inside the art to fill it with texture. If I draw a selection and drag it over an edge, that edge is softened because the patch tool blended them together. Continue to add air bubbles to areas of your latte art until you're happy with the result. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.